just gonna show you how I make my whip wagglers. These are the raw materials: peacock quill, 1mm piano wire, and a cocktail stick. I've already done some ready, cut these into length, trimmed them, tidied them up, cut some of the wire into length, and the cocktail stick I've broke in half and trimmed them up just to go in the thing. So you clip these two, I've just gone by someone that I've made previously. I've gone by the same length as the ones I've made previously. So it's very simple. You put the wire in the bottom, the cocktail stick in the top, glue it in using either araldite or super glue, and you've got yourself a float. The attachments I use, which I think on a previous video I showed you which attachments I used, but I think you couldn't see very well on that one. So, and also I'm going to be making myself some new punches as well, which I'll show you later. Now for the punches, I use a vernier caliper to measure the punches, and these are the punches I've been using. And that one, measure that one, it's about 5.5. This one I've been using, an old one, at 6.5, 6.4 or 6.5, and I think this one's about 7. 6, yes, 7. But recently I've been using these big ones, and I found that the fiberglass is a bit thick and it doesn't cut clean, so I've decided to make some more out of carbon fiber. Plus I need one between that size and that size. So I haven't been able to find any plastic rod that fits through there, so I've been to a hardware shop and bought some wooden dowel. That's 6mm dowel, and this is a piece of pole cut down. So that's the rough end. It don't matter about that being rough, but the other end I've cut off with a Dremel, and that 6mm. I've cleaned these up, cut them off, and hopefully that 6mm fits neatly in there, so I can pull it through, and when I come to stick it in, to glue it in, I will make it about 1.6 deep. That's near enough, 1.61. So just push that down, and then I've got my 1.61 deep. I'll put the glue in, stick it in, and then it'll fit that. The others, where the 6mm is too small, the other ones, the 6mm stuff's too small, and this punch is 7. So I've put masking tape round it, so it could do with being a bit tighter. I might have to put a little bit more tape around that, and then do the same thing and glue it in and make it about 1.6 deep. So the pieces of rod pole trimmed off. I think I've got the right end there. I think that's the 6.6, which is the same as that one. So I've done a 6.6, 6.5, 7, and this one I think is overset and bigger than 7. That's 7.2, so it's a little bit bigger. I'll do that one as well, but I probably shan't use that one. But I'll just—it's just a rough idea of how I do it. Probably been a bit technical with the vernier, but I use it for different measurement. I use it all the time for measuring bits and pieces. Yeah, so that at the tip is about 7. I'm just putting the floats together at the moment, if you can see it. Try and get them as straight as possible. It's not vital. Put more wire in than what you need, and then decide what shot you want to put. Mine are usually 3 or 4 number 8s for the waters that I fish, but you might want more. Then you test the shot, you put the shot on the line that you want. Put the float on, drop it in the water, and it'll probably go under, and you just clip bits off. Clip a bit off at a time until you get it to sit exactly where you want in the water. Rather than shot to the actual float, cut the float to the shot that you want. Stuck now. Got my vernier ready. This is a tricky time. I'm just going to pop a small bit of araldite inside the tube. And then push the. This is a 6mm one, which the araldite has forced some of it out. I'll have to pull it through. It should actually stick. Just rub a little bit of araldite just around there. Should stick that. I'll just push it back slightly and then push it again. Push it in again to get it the right depth. should make a 6mm punch. I'll do the same thing with all the other floats are now all painted black. I might change some of them to white. I might into red like these. What I would do if I need to change any of them, I paint the tip white and then go over it with a gloss. The punches, I've marked them 1, 2, 3, 4 in ascending sizes. They're all glued up. I'm waiting for it to dry, set at the right depth, and hopefully they'll do the job. I mean, these are 6mm, 6, 6.5, 7, and 7 and a bit. If you wanted to make smaller ones, that's a smaller one. I'm not sure how what size that's about 3 or 4 mil, but it's the same principle. You just use a thinner bit of rod. These are old solid glass rod. They're paintbrush bits, so I'll use anything really. It's the first time I've had the same stuff for four different things. I hope that has taught you something.